What's the next term in the following sequence? It goes 1, 4, 8, 48, 88, 488. What's the next term? Which actually is very easy. And why? That's not so obvious. Well, one is a little strange. 4, 8, 48, 88, 488, and obviously the next one is going to be 888, and then 4, 8, 8, 8. The right way to look at this is to stare at these numbers. Look at this number. What do you see? Well, you see 8, but more important, you see two holes. When you look at 48, you see three holes. 88 has four holes in it. 4 has one hole, if you draw your fours that way, and 1 has no holes in it. So the definition of this sequence is it's the smallest positive number that has n holes in it.
People always get really funny about sequences and numbers that are sort of base 10 specific. This is how you draw your numbers specifically. If you draw your 4 non-enclosed,
it would change the sequence. In that case, if your 4 is non-enclosed, then you would make it 1, 6, 8, 68, 88, 688, and so on. And if you do your 2s in a very fancy way with a hole in them, then the 6 could be replaced by a 2. This is topology. What we're doing is partitioning the piece of paper into parts with using numbers. So if you write down a 4, you've partitioned the plane into two parts, this part and the outside. So it's topology. This one is another base 10 sequence. So, but it's lovely. 61, 21, 82, 43, 3. And the question is, what comes next? Don't get distracted into looking for something that's too complicated. Watch carefully. There's nothing up my sleeve. I'm just going to move the comma. And I'm going to move that comma, and that comma, and that comma. And there's an invisible zero here. And so the next one, get it?
6, 12, 18, 24, 30. 30. So 36. So the one after that would be
42.
Yeah.
They're multiples of 6. Nothing could be simpler. But if you were misled into looking for something complicated, you wouldn't get it.
That is sneaky, that one.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I like it. It's misleading. It's deceptive. Sleight of hand. 1, we get 0. 2, we get 0. 3, we get 0. 4, we get 0. This doesn't look too promising. All right, is it ever going to get more than 0? Yes. 5, we get 4. 6, we get 9. 7, we get 5. 8, we get 1. 9, we get 1. 10, I'll do a couple more to make it easy. 10, we get 0. 11, you'll never guess what we get for 11. 55. What's the rule? Let me show you the answer. If I put those squares on top of the numbers and you look through the window, you have to think like a Roman. V, IV, 4. IX, 9. V, 5. 8, 1. There's a single 1. 9, 1. 10 is nothing. 11 is 55. And so on.
That would have taken me a year.
So, of course, it might not be a legal Roman number. You might have the 1s and the V's and the M's in the wrong order. In which case, the way the sequence would be defined, as you say, that's 0 for that term. Two closely related sequences in the sense that they both have names, they both have slightly misleading names, titles. And the first one are the even numbers. Well, you know what the even numbers are? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, two, four, six, eight. But I would like you to figure out what the even numbers are, too. Now, I have to be very careful. Four, six, seven. Seven is not even. Eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 20, 19, 20, 30 is the next even number. And then 32, 34, 36, 40, 42, 44, 50, 52, 54, 56. Are you getting the idea? 60. Let me continue. 62, 64, 66, 2000. Those are the even numbers.
2000, that was a jump.
Why are those the even numbers? What do you notice about these numbers? For one thing, they're all even. The second thing is that if you write out the number in English, there are no E's in them. One is missing because one has an E in it. Three has an E in it. Eight has an E in it. In fact, there's a theorem. It's an old theorem of mine. Every odd number contains an E. And you can easily prove that by looking at all the odd numbers and check.
Why are they called even numbers?
E is banned. Any other questions? Let me show you another one with a name. These are the emopes. And again, the name is a hint, and in this case, it's actually a legitimate hint. The emopes, as you might guess, well, let me show you what they look like, first of all, and then you can guess. 13, 17, then... It's not 19. You might have thought I was going to write 19, but it's actually 31, 37, 71. And that's probably enough of a hint. Well, obviously, they're primes. And if you look at the name, you see it's prime backwards. So these are the primes, which, when you read them backwards, are still primes, but different primes. So we don't put down 11 because it's palindromic. These are primes which, when you read it backwards, gives you a different prime.
I know what you're all thinking, everyone. What is the largest known emirp? Well, as far as I can tell, it's this, or its decimal expansion is this. Now, if you like these fun little puzzles, I've actually got one leftover one that got cut from this video, but still pretty good fun. I've put it over on the Numberphile 2 channel. There's links on the screen and in the description. And we'll have Neil Sloane back really soon talking about more amazing sequences from his online encyclopedia. Stay tuned for that.